मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे विल बी स्टडी ऑफ क्लास थर्ड सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। योर बुक नेम इज इंग्लिश रीडर। नाउ विल बी स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3। चैप्टर 3 टाइटल इज द मैजिक पेंट ब्रश। अबाउट द लेसन, इन दिस लेसन टेल्स अस अबाउट ए पुअर यंग आर्टिस्ट। हिज नेम वॉज मलयांग। About this, the lesson, Malyang, a poor young artist of China, wanted to help the poor. Once he got a magic paint brush and used it for the benefit of the poor. But the sword chieftain stole it. What happened to the greedy chieftain? In the end, let's read the story and find out. That means, once upon a time, a poor young artist lived in China. His name was Malyang. He found a magic paint brush and used it for welfare of the poor. One day, sword chieftain stole it. Malyang was a poor young man who lived in China. He was a very kind, honest and gentleman. He was always eager to help the poor and the needy. He was an artist. He liked to draw pictures of everything he could see around. After working hard all through a day, he would sit in his room and paint drawing of whatever he could lay his hand on. One night he dreamed as if an old man was giving him a magic paint brush. Use it for the welfare of the poor people, the old man said. When he woke up, he was surprised to see a new paint brush laying near his canvas. From that day, he used the paint brush whatever people needed help. Once he saw that people had no water, no irrigate their fields, he drew a river, and the river came to life. People could bring water from the river for drinking and for watering their fields. One day he saw that people had to face great hardships in tilling their lands, as they had to pull the plow on their own shoulders. He drew two oxen, and the oxen came to life. People could use the oxen to till lands. Thus, whenever he saw the people in trouble, he would use his magic paint brush to help them out. People who were happy, they loved and honored the selfless poor man. Soon the news of Malyang and his magic paint brush spread far and wide. The chieftain of the village was a greedy and wicked man. When he heard of the magic brush, he decided to steal it from the young man. One night he went some of his men to Malyang's become. They robbed him of the magic paint brush and put him to the prison. The chieftain became very happy. He thought that he would use the magic paint brush to satisfy his greed. One day he invited all his friends and showed them the magic paint brush. Then he drew many pictures with it, but none of them could become real, and he felt insulted. He became very angry. He asked his men to bring Malyang before him. When the young man came, the cunning chieftain said to him, If you draw some pictures for me and turn them to life, I will set you free. Mr. Madiang knew that the chieftain was a big man, so he did not want to help him. Suddenly he had an idea. He said to the chieftain, I can help you, but promise me that you should obey your words. The chieftain promised to front of everybody and handed over the paint brush to him. I want a golden mountain. I will go there to gather gold. The chieftain said to Miss Malyang. Malyang smiled. He took the magic paint brush and started his work. He drew his picture of a sea. The chieftain was angry. He said, "Why did you draw this sea? I do not want it. I want a golden mountain. Draw it quickly." Malyang smiled again. This time he drew a golden mountain, which was far away in the middle of an island in the sea. When the chieftain saw the golden mountain, he became very happy. "Now draw a big ship for me. I want to go there to gather gold," he ordered. Once again, the young man smiled and drew a big ship. The big chieftain jumped into the ship. Many of his friends and relatives also go into the ship with him. Then the ship sailed for the island. When the ship reached the middle of the sea, Malyang drew a large babe. It sunk the ship along with the stunning chieftain and his friends and relatives. Everybody became happy to get rid of the big chieftain. They thanked Malyang and praised him for his cleverness. After that, the honest young man lived happily with the family and kept on helping to poor people. Now complete your lesson. Your homework is write world meaning of the difficult word.